El alarmante aumento de las muertes por sobredosis de opioides ha creado una crisis nacional. Los opioides son una de las drogas de uso indebido más común en el país y se encuentran entre las drogas más adictivas. Los adolescentes tienen más riesgos de salud cuando se trata del uso de opioides. Es posible que haya escuchado a personas hablar sobre los opioides y ni siquiera se haya dado cuenta. Oxicodona, Percocet y Vicodin. Y luego está fentanilo. El fentanilo es una droga que es 50 veces más poderosa que la heroína. Con frecuencia se mezcla con otras drogas, lo que provoca una sobredosis, que se produce cuando se toma suficiente cantidad de medicamento para dejar de respirar. El uso de opioides puede afectar todas las áreas de su vida, de malas notas al bajo rendimiento deportivo, a dañar sus relaciones con amigos y familiares. Para los adolescentes, puede dañar más fácilmente su cerebro y causa adicción más que en los adultos. Para explicarlo, le presentamos el video sobre cómo los opioides afecta el cerebro de los adolescentes, hecho por el Instituto Nacional sobre el Abuso de Drogas, NIH.
As teens, people are always telling us what we can't do. Do you ever wonder why that is? Why can't I stay up late? What could happen if I just play for 15 more minutes? Who cares if I smoke a joint every now and then? Let's face it, adults may mean well, but they can't really explain why they won't let us do this stuff. The thing is, there's actually a really cool explanation, and it has to do with our brains. From the outside, the brain of a newborn looks just like a smaller version of an adult brain, but there's a big difference. There's a ton of stuff that still needs to be programmed into a young person's brain. That's where our life experiences come in. How we interact with what's around us shapes our brains until we're in our mid-20s. We can't feel our brains changing, but they are super busy building circuits and programming. So how does this happen? Every little thing that happens to us can change our brain in huge ways. At short distances, our experiences can make or break connections between brain cells. By guiding the creation of circuits, experiences shape our perceptions, memories, and everything that makes us unique. But they also affect our brain across longer distances. This involves the construction of thick bundles of fibers that connect different brain regions. By creating this complex network, experiences help increase the brain's bandwidth, allowing it to work better and better. But you gotta keep in mind, these short and long-range connections are influenced by everything we do and everything that happens to us. But this is awesome news. It means we are the programmers of our brains. Every decision, good or bad, influences how our brain develops. Let's talk about taking drugs, for example. Pretend this is the keyboard you are using to program your brain. Using drugs just for fun or to get high would be like scrambling the letters on the keyboard. Now, if you scramble the letters on the keyboard after the program is written, that can lead to temporary errors or make it hard for the program to run for a while. But if you scramble the letters while the program is being written, the program can incorporate catastrophic, long-lasting glitches. This is why teens are better off without drugs. We are in the middle of coding our brains, and drugs can cause real problems that can last a long time. And yet, drugs are just one of the many possible ways of scrambling our keyboards. For example, not enough sleep, lack of exercise, or eating too much junk food can also harm our brain programs. So yeah, I get it. It's annoying to be told what we can and can't do, but I would rather focus on my ability to shape my brain through smarter decisions. It turns out we have far more control than we thought. We can use this information to choose our own paths and give ourselves the best possible futures.
¿Qué puedes hacer para protegerte? Número 1. Para proteger su cerebro, no use opioides por diversión y solo tome opioides según lo prescrito por su médico Incluso trate de tomarlo durante el menor tiempo posible. Número 2. Defienda su propia salud. Si su médico o dentista le receta opioides para una afección dolorosa, pregúnteles qué tan rápido puede dejar de tomarlos o si hay otros medicamentos para usar en su lugar. Número 3. Retrasar el uso de todas las sustancias. El consumo de alcohol, nicotina y drogas son más dañinos para el cerebro adolescente, que madura completamente alrededor de los 25 años para los hombres y 22 para las mujeres. Sea inteligente. Proteja su cerebro. Para obtener más información, visite www.addictionpolicy.org.